My dad is an avid fisherman, mostly crabbing. In exchange for me going with him, I would always keep a crab as a pet for the day. I take the crab, and it's usually a big blue crab. I would pick the biggest one. And then I would take this crab and walk it around with me. That's what sparked my interest in other living things and what's living under the water. If no one is advocating for their environment, it kind of falls to the wayside. You know, it's not going to be a priority for anyone. We're going to lose a resource that's precious. And generations after are not going to see what it was like. And that's something that's happening faster than, you know, it should. I remember when I went into the environmental field, one of the things that I was looking for was sort of like a role model. I found out there were not many like me. So I had to change sort of like my expectation. Instead of expecting someone to have done or led this path before me, I see it as a way for me to sort of like be an example for other young girls of color. Like, hey, there are other opportunities, there are other ways that you can interact with nature. It's about exposure, you know. Most students, they know about, you know, doctors and firemen and things that they see every day, but if they aren't exposed to different careers, they may not know that it exists. And if they don't know it exists, they don't know that it's something that's obtainable and reachable and something that they can do. Do you guys want to see a crab?
Yeah.
Raise your hand if you want to see a crab. Let's see who wants to see a crab.
All right.
Big hands. All right.
No.
Oh, let's see. Can you see his claws? Can you guys make a claw with your hand? Yeah, that's a big claw. I enjoy teaching students about the joys of nature and about being around New York Harbor because it reminds me of my childhood.
Hey, what is that?
Oh. So let's see, let's pick up this one first. Yeah, let's try that one.
It unlatched.
Seeing the questions and how excited they get about learning that there's fish in their backyard and all the wildlife that's here in New York City that you don't normally think about, that brings me the most joy. They filter water, which is what they're known for besides being delicious. They create habitat for other fish and critters. So if you have oysters, you have reefs. And so oysters provide habitat for fish to hide, for them to find food. And then it can also protect shorelines.